Should you tell a retailer what your zip code is? Well, privacy experts say no, but still many of us do. Susan Hogan joins us today with what we should do when asked this question. And Susan, I've noticed this a lot.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of times I get asked, I just go ahead and give it to them. So what's the problem here?
Well, here's the deal. I mean, we've been used to doing this at the gas pump. We give out our zip code because it asks that. That's sure. For security purposes only. A lot of retailers now are beginning to ask us that. And, you know, a lot of people are like, what does this actually mean? Is it, you know, a problem? Well, what it is, privacy experts say, you know, there is a big problem with this. They find that it's a big deal because with a zip code, it's kind of like that missing piece of the puzzle. And think of it this way. When you swipe your card, you swipe and you usually get your bags, you sign and go, right?
Yeah.
With the zip code, the retailers have your name and they have your credit card information, but and they don't know your address. With the zip code, it gives them that extra piece of that puzzle to put it all together, to fine-tune their marketing, and then to reach out to you. Mm-hmm. So privacy experts have a big problem with this because what it means for us is more telemarketing phone calls, more junk mail for us. On the flip side, though, for those people who like to give out, you know, for those loyalty cards, for example.
Yeah.
And for, you know,
that's how they get you half the time, like coupons or
exactly.
Something.
But some people actually have no problem with that. Me personally, I don't. If I'm dealing with Stop and Shop or CVS, mm-hmm. I don't mind fine having my coupons designated just to me. With the zip codes, it's more on a marketing level, on a broader scale. So for, say, you know, you go to a retailer and they ask you for your zip code, what they're trying to do is hone in on their demographic. So mm-hmm. if you have to travel an hour to go to a particular store and they get your zip code, then they're going to maybe think, well, if we get a lot of people from this area because there's no store up there, maybe we should think about opening up a store in that area. According to the National Retail Federation, that's a big deal for them, and mm-hmm. that's what they're honing in on. Now, in Massachusetts, they just last week said, you know, we have a problem with this. It violates our privacy laws here in the state. Mm-hmm. So now they've banned that, so they cannot ask for your zip code. Rhode Island has not made that move. California has already, and that was about 2 years ago. So really, when you're asked for the zip code, it's up to you. You can say no. People think if they say no, that their purchase isn't going to go through. Mm-hmm. Same thing with your phone number. People will ask that as well.
I'm a bit more skeptical about giving out my phone number.
Right.
The zip code, I feel like, okay, no problem.
Zip code is, I think, more on a broader base. With the phone number, though, they are really targeting you.
Yes.
They can really hone in on you and then target you for particular coupons and for different things. Mm-hmm. So that is a little bit more personal. In this day and age, so many people are so afraid to give out anything, even if it is as benign as a zip code.
Right.
But, you know, it really comes down to you. You don't have to give out that. You don't have to give out your zip code or your phone number. You can simply say no.
Okay, and still get your item.
And still get your item.
Thank you so much for joining us and sharing this with us. If you want to learn more about protecting your information while shopping, head on over to WPRI.com for Susan's report.